Hello, internet world. My name's Landon Watley. I'm the chief for the City of Everman Fire Department down in South Fort Worth in Texas. Well, we're here today in Wisconsin to see our awesome new truck 19. It's gonna be an Enforcer Ascendant 107-foot ladder truck. I'd love to take you for a walk around and show you all the awesome features that we've got attached to this truck. First, we'll start in here on the grill. We've got our station number inlaid into the grill. We've got our bumper line. We wanted to make sure that we had enough storage for both brush lines and trash lines or cross lays for any of our car fires or grass fires. We are in a municipal versus a wildland area, so we do get both. We got the large steel bumper. We went with a red and black theme on this truck. Definitely pops, and it's a whole new scheme for our department. Went with the high-vis fire tech headlighting. Definitely lights up the world, much, much brighter than our normal. Go ahead and walk around. Inside the cab, we chose the Enforcer for multiple reasons. One of the biggest reasons was the one-piece windshield and three windshield wipers, so it's gonna do the job whenever we get those monsoon days a year. On the engine cowl, we did two upgrades. For one, we did the insulation, which definitely drops the interior temperature of the vehicle. Yesterday, we drove for about 45 minutes, and it was cool to the touch, didn't affect anything. We also upgraded to the flat steel piece to organize all of our mat organizers, cup holders, and to organize the poly on top. Gave us more usable space within the cab. A really user-friendly set up with all of our switches and buttons for our aerial master and lighting. Also an upgrade on this truck versus any of our other apparatus, we want the EMS doors. We've never had this on any of our trucks. We wanted something where it was user friendly. We could store driver operator gear, EMS equipment, swift water rescue, and actually carry our rescue or our rehab supplies inside. Much with the theme of the fire service going with the black steel wheels versus the chrome, user-friendly, and I think they look rad. Also on this truck, last minute we switched to the PACCAR motor based on the opinions of our fleet guys due to maintenance, reduced maintenance cost, and the responsiveness. It definitely has its get up and go. One thing with the PACCAR we found was we had to relocate our DEF door, which had to make alterations to our additional storage here. But the way we got around to give us even more storage is we made it a transverse cab. Now we can still store all the normal things that we would have, but we got the additional storage on the top, which luckily we've got access within the cab and from the outside. So now the firefighters can come off the rig, ready to go and ready to fight fire. We did upgrade the seats to the swing seats where they'll, as soon as the firefighter sits up, they'll tuck up out of the way to reduce the wear on the side of the seats and to maximize the workability in the back seat of the area. We went ahead and embroidered our patch into the headrest too, just for that extra touch of customization. On the over-the-wheel compartment, we went with the swing door option, the heavy-duty hinge, heavy-duty options, and pegboard. We chose pegboard over any other option because it's universal, it's inexpensive to find mounting options, and there's a large variety of mounting options, leaving it very, very, very versatile for our needs. We also upgraded to the partition to give us a separate area just for the driver operator bunker gear if they wanted to store their gear within here as well. We did a color match option for our outriggers just so that it matched the rest of the color scheme of the vehicle. On this truck, we deleted the chrome wheel covers. We wanted to go with the rubber option just to reduce any possibility of having wear and tear or scraping. This is gonna be a lot more durable. Obviously, we got our normal SCBA compartments, additional storage back here with our slide out trays, pegboard, and all of the compartments as well. We went with, this is actually a new feature for this truck. Every other door we've had to roll up doors. This one we wanted to go with lap doors. For one, it's cleaner. Two, there's less moving parts, and now we get more mounting surfaces on the inside, being hard surface doors. We can mount things on here, and they're a lot more durable. Plus, they look cool. Got additional storage in the rear. One thing we really liked about this truck was the fact that it had auto leveling. So now, with one push of a button, we can make sure that all of our outriggers and our stabilizing jacks are level, taking the guesswork out of it. On top of the apparatus, we carry a large assortment of supply hose as well. We've got 300 foot, 3-inch, and we'll have 1,000 foot of 4-inch. On this rig, we do have 500 gallon tank with the pump. So technically it is a quint because we can do aerial operations and it works as a pumper as well. Great versatile use of the resources that we've got there. Also, we absolutely, what we're the most proud of on this apparatus is our color scheme and our decaling. The red and black, In God We Trust, this speaks volumes about our department and our community, and we wanted to best represent us and just that pride and that real true culture of a fire service, and we feel like this went back with that, so it brought it together for us. More storage over here. Like the rest, we've got pegboard in it. As I said before, universal mounting options. That way we can be most cost effective as we mount all of our tools and equipment. All right, moving closer to the cab, our compartment right here, as you can see, we've got the RIT decal on here. Firefighter safety is huge to us, and we wanted to make sure that everybody knew where all of our RIT equipment was stored on this truck in case that they needed to grab additional equipment. We've got that decal, and then this, inside this compartment, it'll be set up with just our RIT equipment. Backside of our pump panel, I don't think I mentioned it on the other side, but this is a 1500 GPM Waterous pump. In this compartment, they're called EMS compartments, but thanks to one of our lieutenants, we're gonna go ahead and actually store a refrigerator in here. That way we can keep rehab supplies and reduce any of the daily operations of forgetting to store ice in here. So we're gonna keep bottled water and rehab and refreshments inside of this. We've got another 110 plug in here for charging that as well. One of the big features of the Enforcer cab was the amount of space that the crew inside has to move and to operate, to get bunked out as they're en route to a call. That's the biggest feature of this officer side seat. Now we're back at the front of the cab. Last but not least, the best part of the whole truck is the ladder. One big thing we wanted to do was make sure that we had the most upgraded nozzle we could with Akron. And also we wanted to have our aerial standpipe. We do have multiple industrial developments coming into our city as well as residential. So having that elevated standpipe there was key to making this be able to operate with as a truck company and having it able to run as that high-rise operation rig that we need. One huge key feature of our truck is because we do have a lot of rural area, we wanted to have all of the scene lighting that we could, so that way when they're going to areas that have no street lighting, we can light it up, see the addresses, and see any of the scenes that we're working. On the front and side and rear, as well as the tip of the ladder, we put all the high-vis lighting on there to ensure that they would have adequate lighting on any scene that they ever went to. Awesome feature that we added onto this truck was the rung lighting. We did do the red lighting, for one, to match the truck, and then also it was to assist with any kind of night vision. We didn't want people to use their depth perception during the nighttime operations. The last four rungs of the ladder are colored in green. That would be the best way to show anybody doing roof operations where the tip of the stick was. So definitely an awesome feature, and we did the option to allow the rung lighting to be lit during driving for any kind of parades or showcases that we're gonna do as well. Also, to accent the rung lighting, we did backlight all of our handrails in the same red LEDs to give them a eye-friendly point of reference when they're hopping in the truck. All right, guys, thanks for taking the tour of our truck with us. I want to get a huge thank you to Pierce and to Siddons-Martin Emergency Group. I hope you enjoyed our truck. I hope you choose some of the same options. And just remember, firefighters choose Pierce.